is this tour a dream coming true or something like redefining pop music?
Oh, no, I'm not redefining. I'm just having fun. I'm working with a big 50-piece orchestra, doing my songs, and really just doing something I haven't done before. I never really thought about doing it, but I'm just having fun. The audiences love it. The orchestra's having a good time. I'm having the best time of all, so this is great.
You had the performance with the Chicago Orchestra in 2008.
Yes.
After that, you knew that you want to have a tour like that. That was the point when you decided that you will make this tour?
I always want to do something different. You know, I've worked with rock bands for 30 years. So I thought this time I'll go out with something a little different so people will, you know, be intrigued. So people come, they don't know what they're going to hear. They really don't. They go a little scared, you know. But then very soon they understand what I'm doing. And it's a fun show. It's a fun show.
You also tried filming in the Guy Ritchie movie and everything. Did you like that part?
Being an actor?
Yeah.
No, I've done a lot of film. I've done about 12 movies, but it's not what I do. It's not what I do.
Doing a tour like this, working with 50 people on stage, what is the most difficult in practicing and getting ready, starting the tour?
What is the most difficult thing?
Yeah.
Well, it's a very negative thing. It's actually very easy because everything's written out. It's all in the score. You know, I don't have to argue and think about much. They just do what is written down. The difficult part is sometimes you play in a concert hall that's used to having an orchestra, or sometimes you play in a sports arena like this one. And so my job is to make that experience the same. You know, whether it's a small theater or a huge sports stadium, that's my job. So tonight, it'll be good, but it's not easy.
Were you very nervous before the first show of the tour? What did you feel? What was your last thought before stepping on stage?
Well, there's no point in doing anything unless there's some risk involved. So there's a risk of failure. But I'm not really afraid of failure. You know, what's the worst that can happen? You know, so I enjoy taking the risk. I'm not nervous. I enjoy the risk. It's like if I was a parachute jumper, I'd enjoy jumping out of the plane, even though there's a risk.
I like that sentence, enjoying risk. It's a good one. Is there a place, a hobby, or anything that makes you feel the most creative for songwriting or anything?
Oh, music is where I have the most fun. I mean, I'm most myself when I'm singing. And very honest. I don't think about the past, I don't think about the future, I just think about this moment where I'm singing. And that's a fantastic feeling. It's a great experience.
Do you listen to classical music? Of course, when you have time.
I've always listened to classical music, but I listen to all music, and I don't really separate the different music forms. I don't say, well, that's classical music, and that's jazz, or that's folk music. For me, it's just music. I don't think the barriers between music are necessarily real. I think they're artificial. So I treat them as such, and I go from one to the other.
On your webpage, there's a Rolling Stone interview where you said that you like Lady Gaga. Do you know that she's playing here tomorrow?
Oh, she is? Oh.
She's the one tomorrow.
Oh, maybe I'll come and see her. I know her.
You can stay here because you have a show on Monday.
It's true. I go to Zagreb on Monday, so I'll come and see Gaga.
You really like her?
Yeah.
Like her music or the appearance of her?
Well, she's a real musician. She can really play, she can really sing, and she's got a great musical mind, and she has this whole, everything is, she's in charge of everything, the way she looks, and it's very admirable. Something new, very smart. I like her.
You do a lot for the environment. We know you about these activities. Do you think that if a celebrity, a world-known person stands up to something, and then encourages more people to do or care about it?
No, I can't really speak for other people. I do what I feel I want to do. It's my instinct to do this. What effect it has, I don't know. I don't know, but it feels like the right thing to do, like paying tax, voting, being socially responsible, obeying the law. I try and do all of those things, but I don't think too much about it.
You had your birthday during the tour. Did you have a big party with your 45-member orchestra?
I had a balloon for every day of my life in the roof, and I didn't. It was a surprise to me. And then they dropped them, and I was up to here in balloons, a lot of balloons. I think 50,000 balloons. Stupid.
It was a big room full of balloons.
It was the Albert Hall in London, so it wasn't very environmentally friendly. No, it's very bad. I'm paying for that.
And the last question: you gave us an interview in 2000, exactly 10 years ago, and there was a question that: how do you see yourself from 10 years from now? And you said that if I have the grateful, majestical way of standing on stage, I will. You found the way. So what's the plan for the next 10 years?
Same plan. I'll see you in 10 years.
Okay.
Yeah.